Good morning, children. I hope you all are very fine and happy. Today is our story time. I am reading a story for you. I know you are very eager to listen to this story. You will learn new words with meanings. Stories, telling, listening, and reading help us to develop our understanding. Help us to develop our positive approach towards our friends. And yes, stories help us to develop our language. Children, stories are wonders. So are you ready to listen to the story? Okay, I will read for you. The Advice of the Bear. The name of the story is The Advice of the Bear. There are two boys, Ramu and Shamu, who were very close friends and they were very proud of their friendship. I am reading for you. Ramu and Shamu were close friends and were proud of their friendship. Close friends means best friends, and proud means a feeling of satisfaction to have a good friendship. One day, both of them had to go to another village. So, passing through a thick forest. Passing means they were moving, they were walking, they were going. A thick forest means a place where many trees are grown and they are very close. Ramu advised his friend. Advised means he suggested his friend. Let us see what he suggested. There are dangerous animals in this forest, so we should be careful. Ramu advised his friend, there are dangerous animals in this forest. We should be careful. Dangerous means animals which injure or they hurt us. After some time, you know what happened after some time? After some time, suddenly a growling bear came across them. Oh my God! Both of them were very frightened. Growling bear means that bear, he was hungry and angry too. So this growling sounded a sound from a throat, means growling. This bear came across them. After some time, suddenly, a growling bear came across them. Across them means on their side. They saw him. Shamu ran towards the tree and climbed up. But Ramu did not know how to climb, so he stood there. Shamu ran towards a tree and climbed upon it, but Ramu did not know how to climb, so he stood over there. Frightened. Ramu was very frightened. Frightened Ramu, he had heard something. Let us see what he had heard. Frightened Ramu had heard that bears do not harm dead persons. Harm means they don't injure. I mean, harm means it is physically injuring, physically hurt. So he quietly lagged down on the ground to act dead. He lied down on the ground to act dead. To act dead means to lay down on the floor or on the ground without movement. Frightened Ramu had heard that bears did not harm dead persons. So he quietly lied down on the ground to act dead. Let us see what happens. Bear came to Ramu and sniffed his face and ears. Sniffed means to smell. He went near Ramu and he sniffed to see whether really he is alive or dead. Bear came to Ramu and sniffed his face and ears. Oh my God! Ramu held his breath for a while. Held means he had holded his breath because he was very frightened and he was pretending that he is dead. Ramu held his breath for a while. Bear took him for dead and moved on. Bear went away, thinking that this boy is not alive. Ramu held his breath for a while. Bear took him for dead and moved on. Bear went away from there. After the bear departed, departed means gone away. Shamu, you know this, his friend Shamu, who had climbed and sat upon the tree, he came down from the tree and Ramu also stood up. After the bear departed, Shamu got down from the tree and Ramu also stood up. I was afraid, said Shamu. Why was he afraid? He was afraid because the bear will catch him and eat him. And he is telling his friend, Ramu, I was afraid that bear would kill you. Shamu said in a trembling voice, I was afraid that bear would kill you. Shamu said in a trembling voice. Trembling means a shaking voice due to fear. Then Shamu asked his friend, what was the bear saying in your ear? Friend, please tell me. So what does Ramu reply? Let us see. Ramu replied, the bear told me, stay away from selfish friends. Selfish means a person who cares only for himself. I hope you have enjoyed this story, children. Thank you.